Hi, I'm Patrick. I'm a developer at Google DeepMind, and in this tutorial, I want to show you how you can start building with Gemini and the Python SDK. So I want to show you how you can get started and how you can explore all the models in Google AI Studio and then move over to the Python SDK. Then I want to show you how you can start setting up a chat and ask questions to the model. Then I want to show you some of the cool multimodal capabilities, because Gemini is also really good at, for example, image, video, or audio understanding. And lastly, I want to show you some of the thinking capabilities with the new Gemini 2.5 models and how to work with them. So let's dive right into it. The best place to start building is in Google AI Studio, and for this you can simply type ai.dev and now you land here. This is a playground where you can play around with all the Gemini models and then try different prompts, try different settings, and explore all the functionalities that Gemini offers. And then this is also the place where you generate your API key, and you can even generate starter code and then start building. So let me give you a very quick rundown. So on the right side, you can select the model you want to try. For example, our 2.5 models. You can also select our 2.0 models or even Gemma models. So let me select, for example, Gemini 2.5 Flash. Then here further on the right side, you can tweak some settings like the temperature or the thinking mode, and then even toggle different tools. And now here you can type your prompt, for example, create a blog post about generative AI, and then you hit command enter, and now it's going off. And by the way, this is how fast the Flash models are. And now you get your blog post. And now, for example, you can click here and generate starter code for the different SDKs we have. In this case, I want to do this manually. So let me show you how to set up the Python SDK. And by the way, you find this on GitHub, the Google Gen AI SDK. And this is the installation command you need. So let's go to a terminal. Here I'm already in a project folder and I activated a virtual environment. And now the command you need is pip install Google Gen AI. I also use the minus U flag to upgrade to the latest one. And now we have this installed. The next thing we need is an API key, and you can generate a free API key in Google AI Studio. So for this, simply click get API key. I'm also starting from scratch here. So again, we click on create API key. Then you can generate a new project or select an existing one. So for you, it should auto-generate one. And then we create an API key, and this should take only a few seconds. And now we have it. So now we can copy this away. And by the way, we have a very generous free tier. So all the code I'm going to show you in this tutorial can be used on the free tier. So let's copy this and close this, and later you find this again down here. So let's go back to the terminal, and I recommend storing this as an environment variable. So for this, I'm on a Mac, I say export Gemini, and then here we give this a name, Gemini API key equals, and now we paste in the key that we just copied and then hit enter. And now we can use this in the code. So let's open your editor of choice. And here you can now say from Google import Gen AI. Then we need to set up a client. So we say client equals Gen AI dot client. And here we give it an API key. So you could hard code this. I want to do this in a more secure way. So I import OS. And then here we can say os get env and get the environment variable with the name that we just used, so Gemini API key. And now we can send our first request. So for this we say response equals client.models.generateContent. And now we give it a model ID. So for this we can go back to the AI Studio. And then here you can select the model you want. The first one I want to show you is Gemini 2.0 Flash. So you also find the model ID here. So let me copy this and then go back to the code and paste this in here. And now we also need to give it a prompt. So for this, you need the contents argument. And here we can say, for example, why is the sky blue question mark, and now this is all we need. So now we can say print response.txt and now save this and then go back to our terminal and then run the script. And now this should take a few seconds. And now here we have it. Why is the sky blue? Due to a phenomenon called relay scattering. So now this is working. So now you've sent your first request. The second method I want to show you is instead of generate content, you could also use the generate content stream method. And now you can iterate over this. So for stream in response and then print stream.txt. So what this is doing is this is generating it on the fly, and now you will see it starts generating and you immediately see the results. So this is the difference between generate content and generate content stream. So yeah, this is how to send your first request. Next, I want to show you how to set up a chat. To chat with a model, you can create a chat by calling clients.chat.create. And then again, you need to specify the model you want to use. And here I created a simple while true loop that waits for a user input. And then we can call chat send message and print result.txt. And the chat class is a utility class in the SDK that keeps track of the conversation history. So now we can start chatting with the model by running this script, and I can say hi, and then the model should respond, and I can say, can you tell me about machine learning? And now we should get a response. And now we can keep going. For example, we can say, tell me more about Kaggle. And then again, it continues in the conversation. So this is how to use chats. Gemini is designed to be natively multimodal. So now I want to show you how good it is at understanding different file types and also how easy it is to work with them. So here, for example, I have a image with some cupcakes, I have a short audio file, and I have a PDF file with an invoice. And to use this in your prompt, all you need to do is you can use client.files.upload and then upload your file. And then when calling generate content in your contents argument, this can also be a list. So here you use your prompt, describe this image for me, and then append the uploaded file. And then again, print response.txt. So let's run this. And now if we execute this, it should describe the image and hopefully detect the cupcakes. And the image showcases a wooden table with a variety of whimsically decorated cupcakes surrounded by baking stuff. So yeah, this is working. So let me show you how to do the audio file, for example. So here we upload audio.mp3, and then we can say describe this audio for us. We can also say, for example, transcribe the audio file. It's also good at transcribing. So let me clear this and let me run this. And while this is running, let's see if we can quickly play this.
If the Porsche Macan has proven anything, it's that the days of sacrificing performance for practicality are gone, long gone.
So this works. And last but not least, this is an exercise for you. So you can try this, for example, with PDFs. And then, for example, say, extract the date and amount from the invoice. So yeah, try this yourself if you have an invoice, but this is how to work with different file types. One more thing to mention is that you don't necessarily have to use the upload function. You can also directly append the data in your request. So for this, you can use from google.genai import types. And then here we have the image data as raw bytes by reading this. And then we create types.part from bytes. And here we specify the image bytes and then the correct MIME type. In this case, it's image/JPEG. And then we can also use this image in our request directly. So yeah, these are the two ways how you can append files in your request. And the last thing I want to show you is how you can work with the thinking models. So all the 2.5 models have thinking capabilities. So let's select the latest 2.5 Flash here. By the time you're watching this, maybe this is already a new version. So yeah, keep an eye out what's the latest one here. So what's cool is now developers are in control. So you can even with this one disable the thinking mode. And you can set the thinking budget, so how many tokens the model can get to work through the steps. So 0 means no thinking, and then this is the maximum. So if you just disable this, then it uses as many as it needs. And now if you run a prompt, generate a learning roadmap to learn Python, you get this box here where you can follow the thinking steps. So it's developing a Python plan, structuring the learning plan, mapping the journey, and so on. And then it's outputting the learning roadmap to the user. So this is how to try it in AI Studio. And now to use this in the code, you select the model name. So again, check the model name in AI Studio. I'm using 2.5 Flash Preview, and then this is from May the 20th. And this one is optional, so the code is the same. You can simply give it the prompt here. But now what I just showed you is you can define a config and then specify the thinking config. And here you can specify the thinking budget. So again, 0 means no thinking. And if you specify include thoughts, then you also get a summary and can print it like this. So let's save this, and now let's run this. And then again, we get the response, and then somewhere down here, you can also find the thinking summary. So this is how to use thinking models in your code with the Python SDK. All right, then this is all I wanted to show you. Now you know how to get started with Gemini and the Python SDK. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions or feedback or any feature wishes you want to see from Gemini or Google AI Studio, and then I see you in the next one. Bye.